Just try it.
Hi kids, today I'm using the model mixing interface in Draw Things, the Stable Diffusion client for Mac and iOS. It's free on the app stores. Now model mixing is easy, it's fast, it's not like training a LoRa, it just takes a couple of minutes on my Mac. But just a warning, I was not able to do this on my iPhone, I'm pretty sure I don't have enough RAM there. Now in this video I'm covering how to bake a model with a stack of LoRAs, including converting a regular model into an accelerated model. I'll show you how to safely merge two Stable Diffusion models using weighted sum. And I'll share how to transfer Dreambooth training from one model to another model using add difference. Before we're done, I'll show you how to quantize the model and export it. Now all of this is inside the Draw Things model manager, but before I open that interface, here's a pretty normal workflow in Draw Things. I've set up a Stable Diffusion model and a stack of art LoRAs. We'll open the model manager. It's inside the models drop-down. And the rightmost tab is the mixing window. I'm going to scroll down to where we see model 1, model 2, and make sure weighted sum is selected. I'm going to load the model from my stack in model 1 and leave model 2 empty. And down below, I'm going to load each of the LoRAs that's in my stack in the same order and at the same weight values. I'll scroll up to the trigger word, and I'm going to set my LoRa triggers here, just the same as how I've been prompting. And lastly, I'll give the new model a name. Now the remaining parameters, I'm going to leave alone. I want to use this model's VAE. I'm not going to mess around with that. And float 16 will give me a typical Stable Diffusion model, ready to use. So I hit mix, and I get a pop-up warning that says I forgot to add the second model in the model 2 slot. Well, it's fine, I didn't forget. So I'll just hit continue. Now when a new model is ready a few minutes later, I can remove the LoRa stack and work with the new model with all the same parameters that are already set up in Stable Diffusion. In my experience, the new model will look a little bit better than all of the LoRAs combining. That might be my opinion, but it should also render a little faster, like 10% faster. But if you really want it to go faster, you can bake in an acceleration LoRa. The properties are transferred along with the baking process, so your model becomes an accelerated model. I made a previous video explaining acceleration LoRAs and how that's going to change how the model behaves in Draw Things. So catch up with that video if you want an explanation.
Yes.
If you're sharing these models, let the end user decide their own acceleration scheme. As I've just shown you, it's really easy to bake it in later. But for personal use, I'm definitely accelerating my models. Just remember to add something to the name, like maybe the step count, so you remember which models have acceleration already baked in. Now I'm going to mix two models using weighted sum, so no LoRAs this time. Once I add the second model, I get these balanced sliders for model 1 and model 2. If I raise one, the other goes down, and vice versa. They're balanced to always add up to 100%. And when we use weighted sum, the resulting new model will be somewhere between the two original models. So if I set model 1 to 100%, model 2 goes to 0, and the output model is going to be exactly like model 1. At 50-50, the new model will be halfway between model 1 and model 2. I suggest start with basic ratios like 50-50 or 70-30. There's a place to add a note about your settings down at the bottom of the mixer. So when you add the output model's name again, Draw Things will bring up these mix settings and add any notes that you've added here. Weighted sum is the easiest mixing mode because it can't really go wrong. It's averaging the two models. You won't get any outside crazy spiked values. And if you don't like to play it safe, well, there's the Freeform mode. where you can add a third model, maybe any number of models, I'm not really sure. Also, these sliders are no longer balanced, so you can set any values on any model, like all negatives, or each model at 200%. No, you won't get a 600% model. The sliders don't balance, but they are going to be normalized, so it's going to do it for you behind the scenes. And I have not experimented like that. I don't know what's going to happen. And weird values are definitely possible to use at your own risk. Now the really advanced setting is Add Difference. This takes three models, 1, 2, and 3. It's going to subtract the difference of 2 and 3 and add that difference to model 1. Now that sounds bonkers, but it's for a specific purpose. We use it to transfer training from model 2 to model 1, and obviously they all need to be the same generation of Stable Diffusion for this to work. So here's how Add Difference works. I load my Dreambooth trained model as model 2, and the original Stable Diffusion model it was trained against as model 3. It's going to subtract the base model from my Dreambooth model, and what's left over is just my training data. And it's then going to add the training data into model 1, essentially a Dreambooth transplant. And the last bit of information I didn't talk about is 16 float versus 32 float. Use 16 float if this is the model that you plan to use. And use 32 float if this is the model that's going to be an intermediate step to more mixing. I'm gonna jump out of the mixing tab into the regular models tab. And next to the new model, we have the option to quantize further. If I created the model at 16 float, I can quantize down to 8 bit. And if the model is still 32 float, I'll have the option to quantize down to 8 bit or 16 bit. Quantizing is kind of like cutting a steak into smaller bite-sized pieces. It's still the whole steak, but each piece is easier to swallow. So an 8-bit quantized model will run better on low RAM devices like my iPhone. There's also an option to pack, optimize the model for faster loading, and as far as I understand it, that's just a draw things benefit. It alters the model to be more compatible with draw things, so the conversions don't happen on the fly each time we load the model, and you can unpack those models back into their original form. Now, export is exactly what you'd expect it to be. It will be a self-contained model that can be added to any other Stable Diffusion client. It doesn't have to be draw things. And of course, the trash can is to delete the model. Now give this video a like if you think it will help others. And of course, you can subscribe to be notified when I upload the next one. That's all I have time for today, and I hope you had a learn. I'll see you next time.